Hello and welcome to this quick tutorial designed to help you navigate within the Mid-Willamette Valley High Water Watch website. This website has been developed to provide a single location to access flood-related information, including National Weather Service alerts that are automatically updated in this location here. We have local stream and rain gauge information found here, as well as regional weather and stream level forecasting resources found here. And at the bottom of the page, you will find hot links to all of our project partners' websites. Going back to the top of the page and in the bookmarks view, you will also find useful information on what to do before a flood occurs, as well as sandbagging techniques and other useful information. Now let's focus on accessing local stream gauge and rain gauge data. There are a number of different ways to view local stream gauge data. For example, for a quick look at a 7-day graph of stream levels, you can select on any of these links here for a particular set of gauging stations. For this example, I will select on the Clark and Pringle Creek gauges. Once loaded, a view pops up showing all of the different stream gauging stations we have on these streams. Note that up in the upper left-hand corner is the station name and a quick description on its location. There are also mapping options to view the data as well. In this view, a color-coded system is used to signify the current levels for each of the monitored streams as they relate to the threshold levels. For example, if a station icon is yellow, it means that the current reading is over the high water watch action level. If it's over the flood level, it is orange, and if it's over the major flood level, the station icon will be purple. If you are not sure what stream is closest to you, you can zoom in on the map itself, and once you get close enough, all the different street names will appear. I can also select on the station icon itself, and a pop-up window will appear where I can either do a quick graph of the station data, or I can also look at the station details, which happens to also show me a graph, but it does provide some other information as well down in the notes section. The information here corresponds to what happened during the January 19th, 2012 event as it relates to this particular station. Going back to the home page, we can also see a summary of the data in a tabular view as well by selecting that icon. This view shows you what the current levels are, how old the data is from each of those levels, as well as if the current level is greater than a hot water watch level, flood level, or major flood level. They'll either appear as yellow, orange, or purple on this page. Now let's go back to the home page and take a look at some rainfall data. Just like the stream gauge data, the rainfall data can also be viewed in either a map view or tabular view. For the map view, the default view is the total rainfall in the previous 24 hours. However, you can also use the drop-down arrow to select a specific time increment you may be interested in. For example, I'll go ahead and select 7 days, and the system will automatically accumulate all the rainfall that has fallen over the past 7 days for each of the stations. For a table view of the rainfall data, we'll go back to the home page and select this icon. This view shows a 24-hour rainfall summary for all rain gauges. For a closer look at the data, you can simply select the rainfall increment for a particular station. By selecting the rainfall increment for that particular station, a graph will appear. The graph defaults in a daily view, but then you can also change the increments to get a better sense of the rainfall intensity that fell during a specific storm event. Now, if I want to zoom in a little bit more on this particular event or this 24-hour period, I can simply drag my mouse across the graph and it will zoom in on that data. There are also ways to graph multiple sensors on one graph by selecting the graphing icon here and then selecting the plus button here. Once I've done that, I can then select from the drop-down list a particular station that I'm interested in seeing. Let's say that I want to see how Clark Creek responded to the rainfall that had fallen. I'll go ahead and select gauge height, hit add, then down below, it's now showing that I've got the rain gauge information from this particular rain gauge, as well as Clark Creek at Bush Park. If I graph those two things together, now I'll get an overlay of the stream level hydrograph as it corresponds with the rain gauge data. I can also turn off legends if I so want to, and zoom in on the data as well. As you can see, there are a number of different ways to view the data, and I invite you to familiarize yourself more with the website.